Y bueno, de mis siguientes invitados, él aparece en la serie The Americans y ella en Females in Love. Démosle la bienvenida a Alex Feldman y Nikki Cox. Bienvenidos a Noches con Platanito.
Noches con Platanito.
Noches con Platanito. Ah, good Spanish.
Sí, sí, claro.
Oye, muchas felicidades, Alex. Eres un actorazo.
Muchas gracias.
Y aparte de ser un gran actor, eres papá también.
Oh, yes. Sí. Sí, sí. Muchas, dos niños.
Dos niños. Han de estar orgullosísimos de ti.
They're unimpressed. They're unimpressed. I'll tell my son is five, right? So he says, I was going to New York to shoot the show, and he says, is it Power Rangers? I said, no. He goes, then it's not real.
Así es. Oye, Nikki, y por ejemplo, ahorita que estamos hablando de familias y todo eso, oye, a ver, sé que tus papás son de culturas diferentes.
They are, well, the thing is, they're both from different cultures and they're both so obsessed with their cultures that it's so intense. Like, my dad is Jewish, my mom's Italian. Like, for example, today when we were in the dressing room, I was getting my hair done and my hairstylist had an accent. My mom's like, where's your accent from? She goes, I'm Italian. And my mom goes, oh, I love Italian! And I'm like, oh my God, mom, like, she's just from Italy. Calm down. My dad's the same way about Jews.
Qué padre tenerte aquí, Noches con Platanito.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Y bueno, me imagino que ustedes de niños han de haber sido súper traviesos.
You know, you're bored when you're a kid, so you come up with fun things to do, and it's different. It's just different. You know, but in New York, we did everything was around you. Everything you could easily get in trouble. Then I moved from New York to Jersey, to a suburban environment in Jersey, and there people get much more creative with.
Oh yeah.
With the people, you know, about those people just hang out in a parking lot at like a 7-Eleven.
I do. Yeah. I used to go to New Jersey growing up for the summers, and I remember I was always. It was so weird to me that people just showed up and unannounced. Right. They didn't tell you that they were coming over. They just showed up, which is so weird. That never happens here.
And high school parties in the suburbs are way more wild than in the
city.
Oh,
yeah, they are. They
because
go crazy.
Because people get creative. I had a friend.
They're like in the woods sometimes.
Yeah, in the woods. I had a friend who was hanging out in the woods. I'm like, for the purposes of this show, we're going to call him Jeff. I don't want to incriminate him. But this guy, he was in high school. He calls me up and he says, listen, there's a train that delivers beer from city to city, and I know where it stops. Oh. All right, Jeff. And he goes, I'm going to rob the beer train.
No.
Jeff.
So, that's right. Good old Jeff. So,
unos amigos.
No. It's a friend. It's a friend.
So you're definitely not Jeff.
I may or may not have been involved in this. I'm against all of this. But one day he calls me and he says, I did it. I brought him here.
Oh my God!
And I think he's full of it. I don't believe him. So he goes, "Come on over." So I go to his house. He's got beer stacked like this high all over the house.
How did he take it all home?
How do I know?
¿Tú cómo eras, Nikki? ¿Tú de niña tenías problemas en la escuela? ¿Te portabas bien? ¿Te portabas mal?
I misbehaved a little bit. I got sent to the principal's office every now and then. My worst time getting sent to the principal's office was we had a teacher we didn't really like, and so she left the room for a little while, and she left her phone on the desk. So we sent a naughty text to her husband.
¿Qué decía el mensaje?
It was something about handcuffs and a little surprise and. It'll be waiting for him when he gets there. I was in like seventh grade. I probably didn't even know what the handcuffs would be for if it happened, but you know, it was all about the fun.
Oye, ¿se enteró la maestra que fuiste tú?
She did. We got sent to the principal's office. I had to cry my way out of it. It was a whole drama.
This is what made you an actress.
That's how I became an actress.
Oye, Alex, muchas felicidades, ¿eh? Oye, ahora te vemos en esta gran serie de Americans.
Yes, thank you very much, yes.
Platícame, porque yo escuché que por culpa de tu acento casi pierdes el papel.
Well, okay, so the show's been on for 5 seasons before I joined, and I auditioned for a few different parts, and every time I auditioned, I made a tape here
five
in LA.
Times?
Yeah, 5 times, 5 different characters. Yeah, it takes a while. And then I would send in the tape, and the only thing that the producers knew of me was me speaking with a Russian accent, because that's the only thing they saw on the tapes. Right, so I would kind of speak like this, you know, like a Russian guy, and then finally, when I got the part, I met the producer for the first time, and he says, "Hey, you want to talk about your character?" And I said, "Yeah, absolutely." And as I said, "Yeah, absolutely," he goes, "No accent. You don't have an accent." And they totally freaked out because these guys pay very meticulous attention to make sure everything is very authentic. So that's the first time he realized I speak with an American accent. And I swear to God, for a minute, I thought that was it. That was it. I'm gonna lose a job.
Did you mean to speak with an American accent?
No, I mean, I thought he knew. I was like, the only thing he had seen was my audition tapes.
¿Cómo dices, estoy muy contento de estar aquí?
But the American accent, I'm very happy to be here. But the Russian accent, I'm very happy to be here.
I'm very happy to be here.
Wow.
Hasta siento que me espías cuando hablas en ruso. Nikki, oye, tú regresas a la serie Famous in Love.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Dime algo, ¿eres traviesa también en el trabajo?
Well, yeah, I mean, why not? Life's too short to not play pranks all the time.
Eso sí tiene razón, hay que vivir la vida haciendo bromas, pasársela bien, riéndonos.
I mean, look at you.
Yeah, thank you. Gracias por haber estado aquí en Noches con Platanito.